सो वी आर इन द इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन पेपर नंबर 6 यूनिट नंबर 2. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ टॉपिक कॉल्ड अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. सो बिफोर स्टडिंग द डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम यू शुड नो दैट वट इज डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. सो सिंपली अ डेटा मीन्स एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ सेंसर्स आउटपुट. इट इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी एज डेटा फॉर आवर सिस्टम. एक्विजिशन मीन्स वी हैव टू एक्वायर इट एंड वी हैव टू स्टोर इट फॉर द फ्यूचर पर्पज, और वी आर इमिजिएटली गोइंग टू यूज दैट पर्टिकुलर डेटा. एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम इज सपोज वी आर इन द एरोप्लेन, वी आर सिटिंग इन द चेयर ऑफ द एरोप्लेन. वट इज अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम इन दैर? सो इन दैट एरोप्लेन मेनी सेंसर्स आर अवेलेबल. यू कैन सी दैट इफ वी नीड टू मेजर द फ्यूएल इन साइड द एरोप्लेन, वी नीड अ गेज टू मेजर द फ्यूएल टेम्परेचर इन साइड इट, द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर इन साइड इट. सो मेनी सेंसर्स आर देयर, स्पीड, इट्स टिल्ट पोजिशन, सो मेनी सेंसर्स आर देयर. सो दिस सेंसर्स गिव्स अस अ रीडिंग्स. दिस रीडिंग्स आर टेकन इन टू अ सिस्टम. सो वट इज दैट सिस्टम? दैट सिस्टम इज अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द वैल्यूज ऑफ द सेंसर्स और द रीडिंग्स, वी कैन से अ डेटा, द पायलट एंड द गाइडिंग सिस्टम विल टेक द करेक्टिव एक्शंस. दिस इज वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. यू कैन सी इफ वी सेंड अ सैटेलाइट इन द स्पेस, सैटेलाइट ऑल्सो हैज अ सिस्टम कॉल्ड अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. सो इट विल मेजर ऑल दिस एनवायरमेंटल पैरामीटर और द पैरामीटर विच इज मेन टू मेजर इन द स्पेस. दैट मेजरमेंट इज टू बी टेकन एंड दैट इज अवेलेबल इन अ DAS, दैट इज कॉल्ड डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. सो दैट विल बी सेंड टू द रिसीवर दैट इज अवेलेबल इन ऑन द अर्थ. सो दे विल टेक द डेटा एंड प्रोसेस अकॉर्डिंगली. इट इज अवेलेबल इन अ इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन, इंडस्ट्रियल सिस्टम्स एज वेल. सो इन इंडस्ट्री, सपोज इफ वी टॉकिंग अबाउट अ मिल्क प्रोसेसिंग प्लांट, सो इन दैट मिल्क प्रोसेसिंग प्लांट सेवरल पैरामीटर्स इज टू बी मेजर्ड ऑफ दैट मिल्क. एग्जाम्पल फॉर इफ यू हैव टू मेजर द फैट परसेंटेज इन साइड द मिल्क, वी हैव टू मेजर द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मिल्क, वी हैव टू मेजर द SNF क्वांटिटी ऑफ इन साइड द मिल्क. दिस क्वांटिटी इज टू बी मेजर्ड एंड दैट इज टू बी टेकन इन अ सिस्टम, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम. सो दो द वर्ड इज वेरी सिंपल बट इट कंटेन्स अ सेपरेट, वी कैन से अ बुक. वी हैव टू जस्ट सी वॉट इज डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम, वॉट इज इन साइड द डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम एंड हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प अस इन आवर सिलेबस. सो एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट अ डेटा एक्विजिशन सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ इंडिविजुअल सेंसर्स. दो द सेंसर्स आर देयर एंड देयर मेजरमेंट इज टू बी टेकन, इट इज नेसेसरी दैट वी शुड हैव सम इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सिस्टम्स. एग्जाम्पल फॉर सिग्नल कंडीशनिंग, लाइक टेम्परेचर सेंसर. द टेम्परेचर सेंसर थर्मिस्टर गिव्स अस रीडिंग्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस चेंज. थर्मोकपल इज देयर, देयर इज वोल्टेज वेरिएशंस. सो दिस इज नीड टू बी कंडीशन सो दैट इट विल बी सुटेबल फॉर आवर सिस्टम. सो द सिग्नल कंडीशनिंग सर्किट इज देयर. मेनी अ टाइम्स वी नीड टू कन्वर्ट डेटा फ्रॉम एनालॉग टू डिजिटल. इफ वी हैव अ प्रिंटर एट द एंड ऑफ आवर सिस्टम, we need to convert that analog data into digital and then it will be going to get printed. Data processing is there, means if we need to amplify the data, if we have to filter the data, data processing is needed. Multiplexing, this is the most important part in case of data acquisition system, where the several sensors are there, they are giving us the reading. We should send that reading to the destination using a multiplexing technique. So we can send one sensor's reading at a time so that at end we'll have a demultiplexer where it separates all this data and we'll have a readings of each and every sensors. We need to have a data handling, means the equipment needed to handle the data, computers needed for storing the data, we need printers, we need, suppose if you have to plot the graph, like the earthquake is happening over there, so the sensors will sense the data and our we can say the analog printer, it will print the waves, the seismic waves. So that equipment we needed. We need to associate with the transmission thing. We need a storage systems. We need a display systems. As like in case of a navy, in a ship, we need a display system so that the captain over there, he will look what is the actual thing is happening over that ship. So these all contains a data acquisition system. So only three sentences tells us the story that this data acquisition system is nothing but a very big subject. So in order to optimize the characteristic of the system in terms of performance, handling capacity, cost, the relevant subsystem can be combined together. So what we can do is that we can have a subsystem for each sensor so that total subsystem should be combined together to form a big data acquisition system. So as you know, the environmental parameter is generally in the form of analog quantity. So the analog data acquisition system is generally acquired. If we need to convert that into digital, we can convert it using data converter. So we have to convert it into digital form so that we can have a processing over there, or a transmission, or we have to display it on a display panel, or if you want to store in case of our hard disk or a storage devices, we can store it. Processing, what is in the processing? So it consists of large variety of operations. Simply, a mathematical manipulations, example, for addition is needed of two signals, subtraction is needed, integration, derivation, that is needed. It can be done using this processing part. Also, in case of our data acquisition system, we need to acquire all the data, or we have to collect all the data, and then we have to do some sort of mathematical or statistical operations over there. So we need averages of it, or if you have to need the statistical analysis of the data, we can do it. So that comes in the part of processing. Like if we have to convert the data into more usable form, like the efficiency of motor speed, if you have to calculate it, the torque or the power input, if you have to calculate it, we need all this data processing. So using data for controlling a process, performing repeated calculation to separate signal buried in the noise. So lastly, we'll have information that can be displayed, or we can have various other purposes where we can store the data, where we can print the data, where we can, according to which we can take the action, that is called AI, artificial intelligence, it can be done. This data is to be transmitted into digital form so that we can transmit it over a long distance. Or we can have a short distance like the nearby PC or nearby printer, so we can print it immediately. So this is the processing part in case of a data acquisition system. So what is at the display devices? We may have some sort of digital panel, so where the data can be displayed, or we can have CRT, cathode ray tube, or we can temporarily store it, or we can permanently store it. This data acquisition systems, generally the process of collecting the input data in digital form rapidly, accurately, and economically as necessary. The basic instrumentation may be a DPM, digital panel meter with digital outputs, a shaft digitizer, or a sophisticated high speed resolution devices. So that is needed to be stored all this data that is in the form of digital. To match the input requirement with the output of the sensor, some form of scaling or offsetting is necessary. So this can be achieved by using amplifiers or attenuators. So amplifier will amplify the signals, or attenuator will degrade the signal, or we can say opposite of the amplification. So for converting analog information from more than one source, either additional transducers or multiplexers are employed. To increase the speed with which information is accurately converted, sample and hold circuits are required, and so many things are required. So in case of data acquisition, if we divide data acquisition into different parts, so we'll have a generalized data acquisition systems block diagram, where the one block simply tells us a system, a separate system, we can say a subsystem. Look at here in the diagram, you will see that there are so many transducers are there. So why it is not called as a sensors? Because all sensors can be act as the transducers, but all transducer cannot be act as a sensor. So the transducer, we can say a sensor can be act as a transducer, so we can replace that block by using a transducer. So it will convert, actually it will sense the data, that is a physical quantity, and finally it will convert into a suitable form and it is given to the signal conditioner. So for each transducer there is signal conditioner. For each transducer, for a second, we can have a second signal conditioner and so on, because the sensors are different. Like temperature sensors, someone is measuring the fuel tank capacity of the aeroplane. Some can measure the speed. Some can measure how the tilt position is. Some can measure the atmospheric pressure around the aeroplane, inside atmospheric pressure inside the aeroplane. So that have different sensors. So these sensors need a signal conditioning socket, and finally if we have to send a data, we need a multiplexer. So if we have a separate transducer 1, signal conditioner 1, if it is going to give to the analog to digital converter and we can give it to the output, so we'll have only a single channel wala data acquisition system. But now in this case, this is a generalized data acquisition system where many sensors are there, we can say many channels are there. So these all channels are inside the multiplexer. And multiplexer is nothing but a socket which convert the input, all the input, into a one output form, one by at a time. So the output of the multiplexer will be analog data. So directly we can send it to the recorders, or it can be sent to the display which work on analog data, or we can send it to the meters which runs on analog data. If we need to process it, or if you have to need to transmit it, or if you have to need to store it, to print it, we need A to D converter, where the analog data is converted into digital form and it is given to printers, digital display devices, magnetic tape, transmission and so on. So if we need to process it, we can give it to the computer so it can process it. So this is the generalized data acquisition system. In case of data acquisition system, it depends on both the properties of analog data and on the processing carried out. So we cannot rely on only the sensor's input data. So we have to process it as well. So that's why the data acquisition system comes in the picture. So the sensor's data and the processing data, both data that is needed to us. According to the environment where we are taking the measurement, the data acquisition system can be have a two categories, where suitable for favorable environment means there is nothing else, like the milk processing plant. There is no gravity part in there. There is a favorable environment where the minimum RF interference there, electromagnetic induction is minimum in there and so on. But in case of other data acquisition system, where is there is hostile environment, like atomic energy plant, where the human cannot enter. So what we can do, this becomes an hostile environment where we can put our system and we can monitor it from the far distance using the data acquisition system. That is called an hostile environment. The aeroplane is also some kind of hostile environment where we don't know what will happen. So we need to have a data acquisition system outside the aeroplane as well. So where the tilting is measured on the surface of the aeroplane, the shaft of the aeroplane, it is in the same position or not, and so on. Like in case of a satellite, we need the hostile, this is the hostile environment. So the category may include a laboratory instrument application as well. So where we are measuring some kind of parameters of some system, so where we can say it as a laboratory instrument application, where we are measuring the various quantity or we are doing some sort of research. So in that case we needed some kind of high calibration test equipments, some routine measurements in research, mass spectrometers and lock-in amplifiers and so on. So these systems are designed to perform task oriented more towards making sensitive measurement than to problems of protecting the integrity of analog data. So, systems where we don't need analog data, we need a sensitive measurement. But a system where we need an analog data in case of aeroplane or in case of satellite or in case of navy, where the ship, all the measurements are required. So the classification of data acquisition systems specifically include measuring is there or protecting the integrity of analog data under hostile condition. If we are using this data acquisition system in a lab, we are measuring, sensitive measuring. While if we go in a hostile condition, we need to protect the integrity of analog data so that we'll finally have a correct result. Or such a measurement condition arises in aircraft control systems where it is very hostile. In case of electrical power system or in case of industrial process control systems. So most of these hostile measurement conditions require device capable of wide range of temperature operation, like in case of space. The temperature, we cannot say that it will vary from 0 to 100 degree. It can vary beyond. We need excellent shielding if the sensor is exposed to the atmosphere. So the sensor should sustain in that environment. So we need excellent shielding. We need redundant path for a critical measurement. So where the wire come from that sensor towards the data acquisition system, that should not vary according to the environment changes. So finally, we should have a considerable processing of the digital data acquisition system. On the other hand, the laboratory measurements are performed over a narrow temperature range like 0 to 100 or 0 to 150, which having a much less electrical noise, which employ high sensitivity and high precision devices for accurate measurement and high resolution. So these are the two data acquisition systems environment. One is a laboratory and other is the hostile environment. So if we are setting the data acquisition system, we need to have the important factor like accuracy and resolutions, number of channels to be monitored, means number of sensors are there, how many parameters we have to measure, that is the number of channels, analog or digital signal, which signal is there, so according to which we have to set up the data acquisition system. Sampling rate per channel, what should be the sampling rate, is the system is very fast or system is very slow, so that's why we have to look after the sampling rate as well. Signal conditioning for each and every channel, each and every sensors, and finally the cost of it. So we have to reduce it to the like minimum cost, then we can have a data acquisition system. So as I've told you that we can have a single channel data acquisition system or we can have multi-channel data acquisition system. Single channel data acquisition single channel data acquisition system, I have said that it may a single channel data acquisition system where only one sensor is there, that reading we have to measure, and a multi-channel where several sensors are there, like I have said the examples of ship, examples of aeroplane, examples of satellite, in case of industrial plant. So these systems have many channels because there are so many sensors. So in case of single channel, there is a possibility of direct conversion. We can have temperature sensor like LM35. It gives us a reading directly in terms of voltage. So we can use amplifier to convert direct voltage into analog voltage. Maybe in some cases we need a pre-amplification as the sensor's input is very very low, like in terms of millivolt or microvolt. Then we need a pre-amplification of it, and then we can have a direct conversion. If we need to convert into analog to digital, we need a sample and hold circuit and conversion. So pre-amplification, signal conditioning, any of the above that can be possible in case of a single channel data acquisition system. In case of multiple channel, we need a multiplexer. That's it. Multiplexer, it will multiplex the output of a single channel converter, multiplexing the output of sample and hold circuit, multiplexing the input of sample and hold circuit, or multiplexing low level data. So this is the possibility where the multi-channel data acquisition system is in to picture. In case of a single channel data acquisition system, what is in the single channel data acquisition system? So it consists of a sensors. There is a need of a signal conditioning circuit, or there is a need of A to D converter. And finally, we are going to save it or we are going to display it. So it consists of a single conditioner, followed by an analog to digital converter. And if you have to perform repetitive conversion at a free running, we can have this particular in a loop with internally determined rate. So what is the rate to be measured means at which moment we are going to measure the reading again and again and again. That should be the repetitive conversion. The output are in digital codes in case of A2D converter. So it includes over range indication, means if it is supposed to be like over the range that we the instrument we have, so it should have some sort of over range indication. It should have a polarity information that reading is in terms of negative or it is in terms of positive. Status of the output to indicate when the output digits are valid. So the data comes at the output, it is valid or not. So this should be the including part in case of a single channel data acquisition system. So these digital outputs are further fed to a storage devices or printout devices or digital computer devices or digital computer for analysis purpose. So as you know, the popular digital panel meter is well known example of this, where we can take at the data and we are displaying on the panel. However, there are two major drawbacks in using it as a data acquisition system DAS. Look at the picture. Here the inputs are there. We have A2D converter. We can have a buffer. And lastly, we'll have a output to the computer. So this is a single channel. You can say that there are two inputs are given to the single channel because many a sensor, it gives a two output like a thermocouple. The two readings are taken at the above and at below, or we can say LDR, light dependent resistor. The above and below both readings are taken. So this is becomes the single channel data acquisition system. Or if we have LM35, we can convert this down input to connect to the ground, and the one input that should be connected to the output of LM35. It becomes a single channel data acquisition system. What is the drawback of this single channel data acquisition system? Because it is slow, a single channel data acquisition, the BCD has to be changed into binary coding if the output is to be processed by digital equipment. If suppose the output that is comes from A2D converter is in terms of BCD, so it should be changed to the binary coding and then it should be given to the digital equipment for processing purpose. So that's why this is the drawback of the single channel data acquisition system. Now if it is free running, means if it is fast, so the data from the A2D converter is transferred to the interface register at a rate determined by the DPM itself rather than command beginning from the external interface. So if it is very very fast, then it should be a limited speed so that A2D converter can be convert the reading. If the analog data is fed, digital conversion is there, it requires some time for the A2D conversion. If it is suppose a 5 millisecond time is required to convert analog data into digital one, but the input data is coming with a rapid speed, like it is coming at 1 millisecond each moment, 1 millisecond. So we cannot convert all the data and that particular A2D converter will lags. So there is a solution that the rate determined by DPM itself, it should be the rate where the input should be fed, or commands that from the external interface, and that should limit our input. So this is the drawback of the single channel data acquisition system. So what is in case of single channel data acquisition system? We have A2D converter, analog to digital converter. So in case of maybe FY, in case of SY, we have seen analog to digital converter. So what this analog to digital converter that used for the DAS applications are usually designed to receive external commands and then convert data from analog to digital or just hold for the conversion. So the command will tell us to convert or to hold. For a DC or low frequency signal, a dual slope type of converter is often used. So why dual slope is used? Because it has a linear averaging capability and has a small null response for frequencies harmonically related to the integrating period. In case of a dual slope technique, these are useful for converging low frequency data. We can talk about thermocouple. It is having a low sluggish response, we can say. So we can use this dual slope technique over there. The most popular type of converter for data system application is the SAR, successive approximation register type ADC, because it is capable of having high resolution, high speed, and with a moderate cost. So the conversion time is very, very low, that is of 10 microseconds. So it have a resolution of 0.1%, about 1 hold per millisecond. So if we need to be a fast conversion needed, we can go for successive approximation register. If we need a very slow conversion, we can go for a dual slope type of A to D converter. So if we need very highest speed, so this can be obtained by preceding the A to D converter by a sample and hold circuit. So what is sample and hold circuit? It will be with the successive approximation type of ADC. So it is working on very high rate of input change. So what we need is that we need A to D converter with sample and hold technique. So sample and hold technique means it will sample the data whenever told, and it will hold the data till the sample data is converted. So why we need a sample and hold circuit? Because if at a higher rate of input change, the latter generates substantial non-linearity errors, because it cannot tolerate changes during the conversion process. Means if the conversion is going on at the same time you are giving input, then there will be a kind of non-linearity error. So that's why, unless and until the conversion is complete, we have to hold the data, and then if the conversion is completed, again we have to give the signal that it should sample the data. So the direct digital conversion can be carried out near the signal source is very advantageous in case of where the data needs to be transmitted over a noisy environment. So if suppose the system is there in aeroplane and we need all the systems information back at the earth, means at the earth station. So if the analog data is taken from that all sensors and that is sent towards the earth, and then the digital conversion is done, and then the data is processed and so on, so it will make some sort of error. Why? Because the data that is coming from aeroplane towards the earth station, that is the analog data, though it is amplified one, there may be a problem of the noisy environment. So what we need? We need to convert the digital conversion in there only. So we have to convert the data there in the digital inversion where the signal source is there. So finally, the digital conversion all is done, and all output, we can say a perfect output, that should be sent to the earth station, and then they can do processing over it. Pre-amplification and filtering. You can see the circuit over here. We have seen the circuit. This circuit is an instrumentation amplifier. An instrumentation amplifier where this is one input, this is the other input, and we are having up output of the instrumentation amplifier is given to the A to D converter, and it is given to the buffer, and it is given to the computer. So the buffer, A to D converter give the status to the buffer, and buffer give the command to the A to D converter that now the conversion is complete, give me the data. So this is the way sample and hold circuit will work. So in case of low resolution A to D converter, where we have 8 or 10 bit of A to D with a single ended out input and have a normalized analog input range from 5 to 10 volt, we can say unipolar or bipolar. You can see the circuit over here. So this is analog pre-amplifier gain of 1000. So using the instrumentation amplifier, we can have the pre-amplification of the input signal, and then it is given to the A to D converter for the conversion into digital, and finally to the computer. For a signal level which are low compared to input requirement, amplification may be used in order to bring up the level of the input to match converter input requirement. So optimum use can be made in terms of accuracy and resolution. The amplifier used has a single ended input or differential input. So we can go for 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier. In case of accuracy, linearity, gain, stability, these are the specifications that should be carefully considered. So it will ensure that the system is not affected by any limitations. If the input signal are to be physically isolated from the system, the conductive path are broken by using transformer couple or optocouple isolation amplifiers. So if suppose the reading is in terms of two systems, one system is very highly stable and other system is unstable. So if you have to combine them together, we need to have isolation part. So where we can go for transformer coupled isolation or we can go for optical coupled isolation. So this technique will be advantageous for handling the signal from high voltage sources or transmission towers. In biomedical application, such isolations becomes very essential. So pre-amplification can be coupled with active filter before processing of data in order to minimize the effect of noise carriers and interfering high frequency component. So after the pre-amplification, we can have a filter. So it will process the data. It will minimize the effect of noise and high frequency. If we go for a multi-channel DAS, you can see the multi-channel DAS where we have analog signal 1, analog signal 2, analog signal 3 and 4. We can connect so many analog signals over there. So these are nothing but the transducers or sensors. What we need in case of a multiplexer is that we need a scaling, we need amplification, we need signal conditioning of each and every analog signal data. And finally, the output of all this will be given to the multiplexer. So multiplexer will feed that data to sample and hold socket. It will fold, fade to A to D converter. It will have a logic. So that logic will do give us the command to the sample and hold circuit that you should hold or you should sample. It is also gives to multiplexer that you should multiplex the data to the sample and hold circuit. Finally, the analog data, it is converted into digital, goes to the buffer, and the buffer it will given to the computer or the data transmission. So this is the way the A to D converter with multiplexer and signal conditioning circuit is a multi-channel analog multiplex system. So the most efficient utilization of time, the multiplexer, it made to seek the next channel to be converted while the previous data stored in the sample and fold is converted to digital form. So what the multiplexer will do, it will give the reading of one sensor to the sample and hold socket and it will hold unless and until it is told by the logic that it should take the next sensor's reading. So this is the way the multiplexer will work. So when the conversion is completed, the status line from the converter causes the sample and hold circuit to return to the sample mode and acquire the signal for the next channel. So whenever this logic tells us the multiplexer, whenever the conversion is completed, it will tell us to sample the data. It is also tell the multiplexer to take the data of the next sensor. So on completion of acquisition, either the immediate or upon command, the sample and hold circuit is switched to the fold mode. The conversion begins again and the multiplexer select the next channel. So method is relatively slower than the system where sample and hold circuits are outputs or even A to D converter outputs are multiplex. But it has the obvious advantage of low cost due to sharing of the majority of subsystem. So what is the use of multiplexer? It will slow down the data acquisition system called DAS, but it will not going to increase the cost of the system. So we can have the multiplexing of the output of sample and hold data. So these sample and hold datas can be multiplexed and it can be given to the analog to digital conversion and lastly interfaced and finally to the transmission or a processing system. So sufficient accuracy in measurements can be achieved even without the sample and hold in cases where signal variations are extremely slow. A large number of channels are to be monitored at the same time synchronously but at moderate speed. The technique of multiplexing the sample and hold circuit, it is very much particularly attractive. So now economically feasible to employ an A to D converter for each analog input and multiplex the digital output. So we have analog data for signal conditioning where sample and hold circuit is there. So many channels will be there. It goes to the sample and hold circuit to the A to D converter. When the conversion is complete, it tells sample and hold circuit to sample again. Finally, it goes to the processor. Processor will process the data, go to the buffer, and finally a digital multiplexer. So each analog to digital converter is assigned to an individual channel. The conversion rate of the A to D need only be as fast as needed for the channel. So compared to the higher rates that would be needed if it were used in a multi-channel analog multiplex system. So this is the multi-channel DAS using digital multiplexing. In such case, we need a sub-channels where so many channels are there that not require some kind of sample and hold and A to D. So it is a very sluggish response from these sub-channels. It gives to the multiplexer and one by one that will be fed to the one subsystem. So the timing will be there. So it will tell us the multiplexer to give the other one. So sample and hold circuit will sample the data. If the conversion is completed, it tells the sample and circuit to sample the data as well as timing circuit to tell multiplexer to send the next signal.